Hi, it's Susanna Troy. I don't feel well. First of all, I want to say shame on the New York Times, shame on Huffington, shame on anyone who's trying to say that something good came out of CityTime, because the $500 million we got back was a sham cover-up, a backroom deal, in my opinion, to cover up far bigger corruption that goes all the way back. And Richard Valchik's letter, whistleblowing letter, he was then the office payroll, head of office payroll. 2003, February, he's calling out all this corruption, in my opinion, SAIC. And the bottom of every page is Mike Bloomberg and Bill Thompson's name. So Bill Thompson, you shouldn't be running for mayor. Ditto for Christine Quinn, who's protected by the New York Times. She brushed aside two investigations into CityTime brought by Tish James. The other thing is great news, Hiram Montserrat is going to jail finally for something. And is Juliet Ferraris going to follow is a question, or is she going to be protected? As way too many people from Albany to City Hall are protected that belong in jail, and the corruption is just so ingrained and accepted in this culture, it's disgusting. Why do New Yorkers have a higher threshold for corruption than our tallest skyscrapers? It's just wrong. Wake up, New Yorkers. I don't feel well. I don't know what I have to do to wake up you guys. But it's like Vito Lopez and his crew. You have Larry Seabrook, in my opinion, Christine Quinn, Mike Bloomberg, Team Bloomberg, Vito Lopez and his proteges. Wake up, New Yorkers. Wake up.